typical language processing system. So the compiler looked as a block, but remember the compiler, there are lots of other loader and linker, the outside compiled code has to be combined, and that then it will be go to the main memory, dumped to the main memory by the linker, and loader collects the independently compiled coded, and you know the all the coded should be relocatable. Relocatable means the at the time of your computer how much it is the memory is occupied, they produce relocatable code. So the we are basically concentrating on compiler here, but we should be aware of our surroundings. And another more interesting thing is the when the compiler design course is originated, right now it is more towards interpreter based course like Python. So we should be aware of that also as well. We'll try. So next is, see here, it is basically interpreter, like it is a maybe Java virtual machine or Dalvik virtual machine, like Android or Python virtual machine. Right now the all the comes a virtual machine, and maybe this translator is only one pass. Typically compiler are two pass minimum. First pass the lexical analysis, then parsing and little bit of semantic intermediate code generation is done in the first pass, and second pass the final code generation. So but here in intermediate code this year only the single pass. So these are the technologies, we'll see it in our, yeah, this is the as for the compiler stages. We have lexical analysis, the Lexim, or this is already covered. This is, I repeat here, it is it's a collection of finite state machine. The finite state machine detect the whether it is the integer or floating point number as per the programming convention and all. So this is a, and it is only the finite state machine, and here most use is regular expression. So you all know the regular expressions. Regular expressions are good enough to catch whether it's a keyword, whether it's a variable, whether it's an integer, whether it's a terminal. So these things lexical. Then the token stream is come. The valid token stream, not valid. A token stream is coming, and we want to see the token stream to the the main token stream. We have to map with on the star symbol S. That is the program unit, and the token. And if you can. Programming rule, if you can map the is the program unit to the token stream, and the output is one and only parse tree, either left to right, or either top down parsing or bottom up parsing, it should be one and only parse tree, or now we call it abstract syntax tree or annotated parse tree, like by any name. So this is a valid, this is a, the grammar is valid. Remember, whenever the lexical analysis, the symbol tabling is being filled up, and when the syntax analysis also the symbol tabling is being filled up. Symbol table is not a single table, it is a collection of, is a arrays of table, it's kind of a dictionary, and we will see that symbol table should be not only for the function, it will be a simple scope of a function or routine may have a different scope. For every scope can have its own symbol table. We'll see why we will go for this. A symbol table is very interesting scenario, and lot of things will be clear up. So symbol table is always accessed, and it is not only filled up by the lexical analysis phase, it is filled up by syntax analysis, it is checked by the semantic analysis and intermediate code generation. This help now it is getting help from the all three stages. Now symbol table would help the subsequent the synthesis phase whenever the code is being generated. This is okay. So we are already end of semantic analysis. Semantic analysis is basically main job is semantic analysis is that type checking. Syntax analysis doesn't go for type checking. Syntax analysis only whether syntax is there or not, but every rule have some semantic thing. parsing. So semantic means it is whether you are using the array pointer should not be a floating point number. It should be, most of the language demands that array pointer should be integer. Python sometimes goes kind of negative, if minus one is the last point. So it depends on language to language, but it cannot be floating point number. And one thing is coercion. Coercion means an integer and multiplied with a added with floating point number. This integer is generally coerced into floating point number. That is called forced type forced conversion. Don't take it. Now the political scenario, it's a forced conversion that is legal in compiler, and that is generally this conversion is. But some cases in Java particularly, say if a string is there, if 2 is a number and plus 2 point is their number, result is 4, and say if 2 is a string and plus is a string, then 22. In the plus is overloaded in Java particularly. Some other language, not all. So these overloading things, like you are, that is called operator overloading. It is some language allowed. So the parse, this semantic analysis should take care. This overloading, this type checking, the array bound should be not outside these. All this thing, type checking thing, is done by the semantic analysis. But it is, I must say, it is a definitely simpler than syntax tree. And only when your syntax tree is valid, then you should go for semantic analysis. And semantic analyzer, we have seen that two attributes, two types of attributes. One is synthesized attribute, like all terminals are synthesized attribute, because the terminals get its value from its value stored. And another is synthesized attribute means the bottom up parsing, like the node is getting attribute is synthesized from this child. And another is inherited attribute, that is L, from L, not R, always L, from either from parent or from your firstborn child, like this, from your elders. But one thing I have mistaken that last class, the L attribute consists of synthesized attribute also. So L attributes are the superset of synthesized attribute, because even if say in case of Java, all the variables has to be statically declared, so it will be definitely L attributed, L attributed. But in case of Python, the variable takes value from the bottom up. So I will suggest you take for individual case like Java or Python and or C++, three interesting languages. C is not that interesting, because C is much simpler language. C++, Java, and their books are available also. I can give you the PDF books for compiler for Java. All the books is written around the Java. This Aho's book is mostly written around C++ and Java. That particular book is only Java. I have found a book on Python also. So you can distinctly see what the role of this thing, because some of the rules will be like static and dynamic checking. In semantic analysis, in C, we all know that our C language is statically typed. It is already pre-declared with the integer variable and all. But whenever you go for C++, whenever object-oriented programming, then it can be dynamic typing also. You don't know it, because in object, when it will be called and when the parameters is coming, it depends on the runtime. So that way, Python is everything is done on dynamic typing, because it is a consist of procedural programming, object-oriented programming, and functional programming. Python consists of all, because in Python, a function can be passed as a parameter, a function can be return type. Unlike C or Java, a function, it can be built into a parameter, that is, that is great. It can return a function. A lot of other things can be there. So here it is a dynamic typing checking, and definitely the semantic checking will be different. And but in Aho's book, they mostly go to the C++. C++ is also interesting, very interesting language. So semantic analysis we have covered. Then it is called syntax tree, but I think its better name should be annotated syntax tree, or annotated syntax is good enough. So then the intermediate code generation. After this only, then you can intermediate code generation. But then while one thing would be clear, one thing would be come to you, like there are two types of compiler. One type of compiler is one pass compiler, kind of an interpreter. There even the lexical analysis and syntax analysis and code generation all in one pass only. That will be maybe faster in response, but code may not be that good enough. But one pass compiler exists, and mostly we are discussing the two pass compiler. That first pass is lexical, full syntax, full semantics, full intermediate code started. This is the first pass, and second pass is the final. This is intermediate code generation will be more fine tuned. What I discuss in one pass compiler, this can be sometimes it can be done by parallelly. So this is a good topic for your next presentation, CFO presentation. You can any of you can take presentation depending on particular tech language. A lot of information is available there. This is it. And another interesting case is that say there are M type of language and there are N type of machine, then if you have a only one pass compiler, there's M for mangoes, M machine, M type of language, N type of machine, there will be M star N, you need the compiler to write. But in case of if you clearly divide with intermediate code, then it should be M plus N, not M star N. So complexity is much less, because nowadays machines can be many type, because you know it may be Intel, it may be AMD, it may be various ASIC chips, maybe Apple A10 chips. So your final code can be different, but initial code can also be different. You can use C, C++, C hash, Java, Kotlin, lots of many languages. So if you go for intermediate code, then your complexity would be M plus N. That is a great advantage. So that is the reason two pass compiler is our main topic of discussion. This is one. Then these are the things it comes from the first chapter and second chapter. Any of the issues, you can take it as your CFO presentation, which is and if you just request you to now you go back your chapter 1 and chapter 2 once more, then it will be clearer to you, because you have already covered till the semantic and code generation. Then it will be more interesting, because compiler is one of the finest code system code you are running and executing, other than OS. Definitely most complex code definitely OS. Then come some people call is a browser. Yeah, browser is also a difficult code, and then the compiler. The three code is one of the best possible coders are written this code. Yeah, this is, you see, the I is here different. Here I is different. I'm taking a simple C program, not C. Can be C++ also. So you see the I is different, so I cannot put it in a single symbol table. That is the basic reason. The symbol table, though I call it a symbol table, it consists of many symbol tables, and it should be part scope. It should be a symbol table presentation should be there. These things will be, this is C++ program, so symbol table would be different. You can see by the scoping rule. And another interesting thing to ask you to think that, then in Python, quite interestingly, in Java, see, you cannot declare global variable within your program. You have to declare anything global variable outside. But Python, within a code, you can declare a particular variable global. That is interesting. Python, that way, you can declare any variable global here within a function, and it will be global to all. So that I wish to mention you. The Python is totally different. That is static now, more or less. We have known that static means everything can be checked at the compile time. That is the reason the C, C++ code is much faster in working, because everything checks at the more or less checked pre-compile time, but Python is not. That is called dynamic scoping, and more challenging it will be. Here, that I already told, is AS attributed driver is all synthesized, and here is interesting. In an L attributed syntax directed translation, directed definition, sorry, then comes the translation. SDT comes there, SDD. Attributes may be inherited on synthesized. That I missed last class, that definitely L attributed definition is a superset of AS attributed definition. And all terminals, I'll tell again and again, is AS attributed definition. Our inherited attribute, the parse tree node, may depend on an inherited attributes at parents or any other simplest unit. This we already know. Yeah, there I want to mention that the same thing, these M plus N compilers can be built with just M front ends and N back ends. The last line is important. This approach to creating suite of compilers can save a considerable amount of effort. M into N compilers can be built just right by M front end, because the front end means analysis portion and back end means synthesis portion. Front end ends after it generates the intermediate code. And next stage is the back end. So it would be, if you have a M number of softwares, packages, and you have N types of machine, it will be always better to go for intermediate code. Yes. So I think here I will briefly discuss three address code, then will come so four address code. So this is a semantic, this is the first portion is the semantic or type checking and all this, then the code, three address code is generated. See, this three address code is more, it can be more towards machines, not machine specific. Three address code more towards source code. Then we will have another three address code which has to be machine specific, whether we can go for this is the here in the code, you can say this first level of after this synthesis first stage is the code modified code, so that we can make more better code, and then the code optimization at the target. When I have selected that this code would be run on Intel machine, or this code is running on Apple machine, then another target code optimization. Then we can have because registers of Intel have maybe 32 registers or 32 this kind of register, 32 this kind of register. Apple may have different kind of registers. So registers level optimization, all the that level optimization, so the machine can, so that is that optimization done at the target code generation. So there we look to machine architecture and what are the different registers. You know the registers, the special purpose registers are there, auto increment, auto decrement, so that your memory address will be auto incremented and all these things. It will be definitely run much faster code. Yeah. So yes, so this is front end that I already told you. This all I have taken from Aug's book. This parser, static checker, it is if it is language static, that is intermediate code generation, intermediate code, then the back end comes. This is the back end is depends on machine to machine. Yeah. So compiler versus sequence of intermediate preparation, that you know it's always there. Intermediate prepare, then analysis, and the last target code. This I have already covered. So with this, I wish to I'll cover the next class, but I'll cover it in earlier class also. But here we have to check it. Some of the important issues I missed it. That I must tell right now. Just a minute. I don't want to repeat this, I have already covered in my last class, but one thing I must tell you that summarily we have decided that bottom up parsing like LR1 or LALR1 is a good one, it can cover all the programming languages, and right now the memory is not an issue. So a table consists of 1000 states or 100k entries doesn't matter, so definitely we will not go for LR0 or SLR, we will definitely go for LR1 or LALR1. LALR1 only advantage is that but it has to be generated from LR1 item collection, LALR1 table size is less, so maybe some grammars LALR1 is good enough, but you see we already showed that we have not proved it that most toughest problem will be reduce conflict. The shift reduce conflict can be easily taken care by this LLR, but whenever the reduce conflict, LR1 is the best one. So say for the argument sake we go for LR1, but whenever we go for the, because the bottom up parsing LR1, then we're coming to the your semantic values, then we have already told you and we have also suggested you. Now right now we are calculating value, now syntax tree is okay, fine. Now you are getting actually the values of the variables, because whenever in syntax rule we are not checking with your actual values first. Now whenever you are generating your intermediate code, then you can take sample values into the syntax tree, and you know the most of the variables terminals will be always is attributed, and most of the LR1 will be helpful for is attributed grammar. But here whenever we go for the LL1 grammar, why you have chosen LL1 grammar? That LL1 grammar is not recursive, and LL1 grammar you have to have remove the left recursion. So LL1 grammar is devoid of left recursion, but this left recursion again come back in your LR1 grammar. It may or may not come back, because LR1 grammar doesn't have problem with the left recursion. But whenever we are calculating values with the semantic, this left recursion can give a problem, and definitely will give a problem. So that I wish to discuss in my next one or two classes, and I'll request you also, this thing is covered in chapter 6 in Nahos, because the grammar in the programming language we have proven it will be LR1, and LR1 grammar doesn't restrict left recursion, so left recursion can go, and whenever the left recursion, whenever you are getting the values, and it will be always a recursion will be there, and your value calculation, then how to avoid the left recursion there and to get the value, because you know this ultimately this LR1 grammar, the values will be stored in the stack, same stack beneath the value. So you know the in the parsing stack, if you think of parsing stack, if it's a single stack, the state value, then the variable, and then the value, these three together. And whenever in this is a convention for this our this kind of synthesis attribute, but if you check at your L attribute read grammar, the value may be before the variable, not beneath the variable. But anyway, in your bottom up parsing, the parsing happens only the top of the stack value, that is the state, stack state. It doesn't go beyond this. Whenever you are taking off and on, that's it. So that thing is interesting. Please go to the your chapter 6 if anybody can wish to present from there, say for how to handle the in semantic analysis the left recursion, how to handle, you can get it. So this is it. I think that I have covered. That is this is I have already covered, and you also appreciate that it is basically a string is associated, and computer is always go for postfix.